Remember family holidays when you were 11? Not a care in the world, right? Wrong. For me, it was when I first realised that I was fat. Of course I wasn't, but I thought I was. I'm Jo Thompson, I'm 23 and I'm from Solihull. With my Fixers project, I want to change the common misconceptions about eating disorders and make people more aware of what it's really like to suffer from one. It just took over my brain, so every minute of every day, all I ever thought about was what I'd eaten, how much I needed to exercise so I didn't gain weight. I couldn't do anything normal without thinking about food and exercise and calories and how I looked, and every minute of every day was that's all I thought about. We've made a film to get my message across, and today I'm showing it to a group of young people. 6 months later, I was in hospital, with only 48 hours left to live if I didn't improve. And at 5'7" and only 4.5 stone, that's not really that surprising. I could show you photos of me at my thinnest, but I won't. I don't want to contribute to the idea the media has that you have to be visibly skinny to be unwell. I've been discussing my experience with an eating disorder expert. So what do you think is the most important thing when it comes to treating people with eating disorders?
I think the message is about early intervention so that children have the confidence to speak to that person that they trust, to acknowledge that they've got a problem and to get help. So whether that's going to their parent or the school nurse, and that parent knows what to do to take them to the GP and to get early help.
Something clicked in my head and I started to realise that, you know, I really, really wanted to live a normal life. I'd missed out on so much. That I was determined, you know, I really wanted to get better. In 2010, I fell pregnant. Previously, I'd been told that I was infertile due to my anorexia, so I was amazed and delighted, but also terrified. For the first time since I was 11, I started eating properly. I had a new incentive in life, and I was going to make sure that my baby was healthy. I now have 2 children, and they're my inspiration to never get ill.
I knew, like, it was a mental, like, disorder, but I didn't know you could be told you're gonna die in like 2 days. Yeah. Like, I didn't think it was that serious. Like,
I find it really interesting as I've never heard of anything like that before, and I've not really been aware of it.
You sort of associate it with thinner people, but obviously because it is a mental disorder, it's not necessarily losing weight that's the issue. It's the mental illness behind it that is more important.
People don't really understand eating disorders, and for that reason people are being left too long without the help they need because it's not being picked up on. And people aren't likely to run and ask for help when they've got an eating disorder because, one, they might not realise they've got a problem, like I didn't, but two, they might feel ashamed because of the way they think people are going to think of them for having it. I've been in recovery for 6 years. I have 2 beautiful children and I'm training to be a midwife. Never give up. Recovery is possible.